Welcome back to Brain Candy TV.
Hey, Brainiacs! Check out this big construction site. Wow, look at all the awesome construction vehicles. Do you know what an excavator is? They're so cool. They use something called hydraulics, which makes them super strong and really good at digging holes. Let's put this excavator together from all the different parts so we can learn how it works. First, we have this big part called the chassis, which holds the bottom parts together. Now let's add the final drive wheels. The final drive wheels have bumpy sprockets, which will be used to move the tracks. At the other end of the chassis, we'll find the front idler wheels. These wheels help the track roll around the front of the chassis. Now we'll add the tracks to the chassis. These tracks give the excavator lots of grip so that it can drive over bumpy ground and mud. Then we'll need some rollers at the top and at the bottom for the track to roll along. On top of the chassis is the swing drive. The swing drive allows the excavator to spin around quickly. This big part is called the house. The house holds the engine and connects all of the upper parts together. On the back of the house, there's a big heavy piece called a counterweight. This helps keep the excavator balanced when it's digging with its big arm at the front. Now we'll add the engine. That's the part that provides power to the excavator and makes everything move. Let's add a seat so the operator has somewhere to sit. On either side of the seat, there are two joysticks. The operator uses these joysticks to control the big arm of the excavator. This part is called the cab. It keeps the operator safe at the dangerous construction site. Now it's time to assemble the big arm of the excavator. This big strong part is called the boom. Beneath the boom, we'll add the hydraulic boom cylinders. These parts can move the boom up and down with amazing strength. The next part of the big arm is called the stick. Now we need to add the hydraulic stick cylinder. This will push the end of the stick in or out. The stick cylinder needs to be connected with hydraulic hoses. One hydraulic hose goes to the front of the cylinder, and one goes to the back. We'll see why this is important later. At the end of the stick, we have the bucket. The bucket is the part that helps the excavator dig deep holes and lift lots of rocks and dirt. The pointy teeth at the end help the bucket cut into the hard ground. This part is called the H-link because it's shaped like a capital letter H. These parts are called dog bones. Don't get too excited, Lizzy. They're just shaped like dog bones, but you wouldn't want to chew on these. The dog bones are used to connect the H-link to the stick. Finally, we'll add the hydraulic bucket cylinder to connect to the H-link, along with more hydraulic hoses so we can control the bucket. Awesome! Our big, powerful excavator is now complete! Do you want to know the secret to why excavators are so strong? It's something called hydraulics. Let's learn how it works. Inside the excavator, there is a pump that pushes hydraulic fluid, like engine oil, really quickly through small tubes. The fluid then goes into one end of a hydraulic cylinder, here or here. Inside the cylinder, there is a piston, which separates the fluid coming in from each end of the cylinder. If you want the piston to come in, you pump the fluid, shown in red, into this end. If you want the piston to go out, you pump the fluid, shown in blue, into the other end. When the high-speed fluid from the tubes moves into the much wider cylinder, it slows down, but it pushes against the piston with much greater force. So by controlling the fluid going into each end of all the cylinders, you get a super strong excavator arm. Pretty cool, huh? Hey, Lizzy, do you want to hop inside the excavator and show us how it works? Okay, let's join Lizzy in the cab and see how she controls all the different parts. Before we get started, we have to unlock the safety lock lever so Lizzy can use the controls. These handles are used to drive each track. To move forward, Lizzy will push both of the handles forward. To move backward, Lizzy will pull the handles back. To turn the whole excavator, we can make one track go backward and one track go forward, like this. But we don't always have to use the tracks to turn the excavator. We can also swing just the house by pushing the left joystick to the sides, like this. Now for the really fun part. We can use the other joystick movements to control the big, powerful excavator arm. To move the boom up, we'll pull the right joystick backward. To lower the boom, we'll push the joystick forward. To extend the stick, we'll push the left joystick forward like this. To retract the stick, we'll pull the left joystick backward. Finally, to dump the bucket, we'll push the right joystick to the right. To curl the bucket in, we'll push the left joystick to the left. Awesome! Now we know the main controls of the excavator. All right! Let's use our new skills to take out those heavy rocks from the hole in the construction site. It's so powerful! It has no problem picking up all those heavy rocks. Hey, here comes the dump truck to take away the rocks. Let's dump them into the dump box. Nice work, Lizzy. Let's get another load. Great job! Now the dump truck can take all those rocks away. Thanks, truck driver! Wow, that was a fun day at the construction site. We learned so much about excavators and hydraulics. What do you want to learn about next? Hey, Brainiacs! Click here if you want to see more of our fun videos. Learning is cool, and I'm so glad you're here to learn with us. And if you keep learning, you can be anything you want to be when you grow up. Don't forget to subscribe so you won't miss any of our new videos. Thanks for watching, and see you next time.